Hey guys, Andrew McFarlane here from StartAJuiceBar.com. Hope you're happy, hope you're healthy and inspired to launch your businesses or grow your existing businesses. Today, we are talking about why the size of your location matters. We'll talk about some location sizes, what you can and cannot do with certain sizes, depending on the volume, all the considerations around location size, because if you are opening a storefront, this is going to be an important consideration that you take into account. And there's many things I'm sure you're not aware of when it comes to considering location size, so you're going to want to stay till the end of the video. But before we dive in to today's topic of conversation, if you are new to the channel and you don't know who I am or what we do, over the last decade, myself and our company has had the pleasure of supporting hundreds of entrepreneurs all over the world launch and scale successful juice concepts, smoothie concepts, acai bowl businesses, juice trucks, all alike, as well as running our own businesses in this arena. So all the information on this channel is coming from that wealth of experience. Early invitation, press the like button. Thank you, I appreciate it. Subscribe to the channel if you're not yet and hit the notification bell. All these things are going to allow you to get alerted when we get and release new content so you can stay informed and educated and empowered. Now, let's dive in. So you're in the situation, you're looking for a storefront. There's all these various variations of sizes that you can consider depending on your model. The first thing that I wanna break down when it comes to considering location size is you want to consider what type of service and experience you want your customers to have. Now, one of the biggest distinctions that you're going to think about is, are you in a downtown area? Are you in a suburban or rural environment where people often go to cafes and juice bars as destination points? Do your customers have families where they're going to come into an environment with kids? And kids tend to take up a lot of space. They move around a lot. If this is the case, you're going to want to take that into account with how much space you need in your retail section, okay? As well as how much space you're going to need in total, which includes the other part, which we call the back of house, which is your kitchen. So I am going to give you some specific numbers and we're going to dive into that as well as it relates to volume of sales, etc. But diving into that a bit more deeply, if you're in a downtown environment, and even if you're not, even if you just decide, hey, I want to have a business that is simply serving people takeout. There's no seating or very, very little seating. And I simply want most of my business to be the kitchen portion. Okay, great. How much space do you need? Well, that depends on two factors, okay? What is on your menu and therefore what kind of equipment you need and how you need to be able to fit that into a space in a way that is compact and efficient. And two, what kind of volume of business you're planning on doing. Because the more sales that you're going to do, the more storage space that you need in order to have the inventory to produce the product to then account for those sales. So that's something you're gonna wanna consider. But I can tell you from personal experience, our very first location was quite small. We had about 400 square feet and that included a bathroom in the actual location. And we were able to do close to $3,000 a day and still have space. We probably could have grown even more to get to even $4,000 a day. So depending on how you organize your inventory, if you do it intelligently, you can do a large volume of business in a small space. Granted, with this location, we had outdoor seating. And so if you want to take that into account, maybe you could say there was an extra 200 square feet. So give or take 400 to 600, depending on how you calculate it, okay? If you're in an environment where people need more seating, you might start getting towards looking for locations that are 1,000 square feet, 1,500 square feet, maybe even 2,000 square feet, depending on the volume of sales, etc. We do have clients that do great sales and they do have locations that are closer to 2,000 square feet. Now, the one thing that I need to mention in all of this that is very important is you want to avoid having a location that is too big. What are the implications of having larger locations? Because larger and bigger isn't always better. The first thing is that it's going to make everything more expensive. And I'm going to break this down, not just from a construction standpoint, which is number one, it is going to make your construction more expensive because you need more materials and it's going to take more time because you have to build out your place, and that extra square footage is going to take more time and therefore cost you more money in time. The second thing is it's going to cost you more money in labor just on an ongoing basis because it takes more energy, more people to maintain a larger space. Now, some of this may be obvious to you or maybe not, but you have to think about that. What is your labor expenditure going to be just because it takes more time to clean? And then on top of that, it's going to cost more materials. So when it comes to, let's say just as an example, cleaning a smaller space versus cleaning a larger space, it's going to require more soap, more, you know, towels, utensils. You're probably going to go through mops faster. There's all kinds of things that it implies when you have a space that is larger. So bigger isn't always better. And this is why finding the ideal size is really important when it comes to maximizing the efficiency and cost and production time and everything in your business. But there is no one size fits all, okay? Because like I said, from the very beginning, let's just kind of go through the bullet points of all of this. The first question you want to ask yourself is, what kind of business model do you want to have? Do you want to have a place that is more community oriented, where people can sit down, people can bring their families, their friends, and really enjoy your product in your store? Or do you want to have a space that's strictly takeout? Those are going to require two different sizes. And then the next question you want to ask yourself is, what amount of products am I going to sell? And therefore, how much equipment will I need and how much space will that equipment need to produce that product in a reasonable fashion? So then you have to ask yourself, what projection of sales is my business going to do? Because if I'm going to do $1,000 a day versus $2,000 a day, $3,000 or $4,000 or more, how much space do I need from a refrigeration standpoint, storage, etc.? A lot of you guys know my story. I started with a truck and we hit a ceiling. When we did $800 to $1,000 a day, we didn't have enough space in the truck to keep selling more product because we ran out of inventory. That's what catalyzed me on my journey to opening a storefront. So this is important when it comes to the size of your location, right? Then the next thing you want to think about is just overall expenditure, realizing that the larger the location gets, the more it's going to cost from a labor standpoint, meaning the amount of people that you need and how much time it's going to take them to maintain that space slash produce the product, right? Because if your space is really big and they have to walk around a larger space, even though it might seem minimal, everything accumulates and adds up over time. So this is something that's very important. So like I said in the beginning, it's not that there's a right or wrong answer. On average, just to give you some more concrete points, on average, juice bars will generally have between 800 to 1200 square feet, give or take. Does that mean that you have to be at 800, 1200? No, you might find a location that's 700 or even 600 and you can make it work, or 1500 and you can make it work. But generally, you don't want to look for a location that's going to be 2,000, 2,500 square feet unless you really plan on doing a large volume of business, right? And you're going to be in an environment where people are bringing their families and sitting down, and most of that space would be connected to retail. So I hope this helps clarify the importance of why size matters in your business and things that you need to think about when and before you sign a lease and are looking for locations. If you need support with your business, this and everything else, as you may or may not know, we have a full spectrum development firm. This is what we do. Reach out to us. Don't be shy. I know a lot of people, I talk to them and they think, oh, I'm a little intimidated. We can talk about it. We'll see if we can help you depending on where you are. It's better that we talk to you sooner than letting you make some mistakes in your business and then you can't go back from them. So reach out to me personally at andrew@startajuicebar.com. Would be happy to talk to you. If you haven't pressed the like button yet, now's your final chance to do it. You don't want to miss this. You're going to regret it if you don't. Thank you. Subscribe to the channel. Hit the notification bell. Follow us on Instagram @startajuicebar. We have exclusive content that we only release there. And then lastly, if you like podcasts, the Juice Bar Experts podcast, we have a show on Spotify and on iTunes, and it's on our website too. Really easy to find. Until next time, hope you guys are happy and healthy. This is Andrew McFarlane with StartAJuiceBar.com. See you guys soon. Hope you guys have been enjoying the video content. If you are inspired to launch your juice business, but you're not exactly sure what steps to take, for you, we've created a free ebook, 15 Steps to Starting a Juice Business from Scratch. This is going to give you a high-level overview of everything you need to do from where you are now all the way to opening your business. Now, if you want to go even deeper, we've created an online course, the Juice Bar Master Blueprint. This is going to go into great detail into every aspect of starting your business, everything from branding to menu development to finding the right location, the equipment that you need, and so much more, all the way to launching your business. There's links for both of these in the description below. I know you're going to find a lot of value out of them. As always, hope you guys are happy and healthy, wishing you a lot of success, and I'll see you at the next video.